Hey guys, how are you all and welcome to my channel. So today I'll discuss one requested topic, that is Antonin Artaud's views on Oriental and Occidental theatre. So from this session, I'm sure that he will have a clear concept on what is Oriental Occidental theatre and what is Antonin's view regarding it and why Antonin himself supports Oriental theatre, okay? So he is basically a French dramatist, he's a French poet, essayist, actor and obviously theater director. And he is widely recognized as one of the major figures of 20th century theater and the European avant-garde theater. So that's why it is now obvious that Antonin Artaud has contributed greatly to the development of modern theater, as well as we can say that to the contribution of French theater. And let us know the full name of Antonin Artaud, that is Antonin Marie Joseph Paul Artaud. Friends, you can also pronounce Artaud as Artaud. So as Antonin Artaud was a French theatre director, that's why he recorded his ideas on theatre in the books like Le Théâtre de la Cruette and The Theatre and Its Double. Okay, and The Theatre and Its Double is a collection of essays. And actually in The Theatre and Its Double, he talked about the Oriental and Occidental theatre. And there are total 12 essays in this book named The Theatre and Its Double. And maybe in essay number 5, which is entitled as Oriental and Occidental theatre, he talked about the Oriental as well as Occidental versions of theatre. So now let us discuss that. What is the difference between Oriental and Occidental? So we can say that Occidental is used as an antonym of Oriental, as well as Oriental is used as an antonym of Occidental. So that's why Occidental represents the West and Oriental represents the East, okay? So now let us talk about Occidental theatre. So actually in Occidental theatre, words or dialogues are everything. This type of theatres are actually based on scripts and written language as well as dialogues. Here you will find the supremacy of speech over everything, okay? So here Occidental theatre basically forsook or lowers the mise-en-scene to an inferior level of art. So what is mise-en-scene? So mise-en-scene actually means the props, the makeups, the costumes that is used in theatre, in films, okay? So according to Artaud, the Occidental version of theatre lowers the mise-en-scene because it gives more emphasis on dialogues, on words, okay? But according to Artaud, a theatre should follow all the things that a drama needs. Means the mise-en-scenes, then musical score apart from just dialogues, okay? And mise-en-scene actually holds an important role in theatre because the art of mise-en-scene needs to create a visual materialization of speech which will be played on stage as a part of drama. So in the essay called Oriental and Occidental Theatre, Artaud criticizes the Occidental version of theatre as he says that for Occidental theatre words are everything and there is no possibility of expression without it. And thus, he supports Oriental version of theatre, most specifically to the Balinese theatre. It is a kind of theatre that is enacted by the people of Indonesia, okay? And friends, if you want to know about Balinese theatre in more details, then please check out the essay number 4 of the book, Theatre and Its Double. So, Balinese theatre actually uses a kind of picture, abstract figures, that was used in ancient Egypt, okay, as scripts. And those figures actually convey some concrete meanings. According to Artaud, the Balinese theater has revealed to us a physical of non-verbal idea of the theater, in which the theater is contained within the limits of everything that can happen on stage, independently of the written text. Whereas the theater, as we conceive it in the Occident, has declared its alliance with the text and find itself limited by it. So here he is basically saying that Balinese theatre uses the non-verbal idea of theatre in which the theatre can portray everything that can happen on the stage, okay? And on the other hand, Occidental theatre, Occident version of theatre is limited on the text only. It basically relies on text or scripts or words, we can say. But Artaud actually is not wholly rejecting the importance of speech in theatre. But he just says about a shift in role and function of speech, when it comes to theater. It means that apart from speech, apart from the function of speech, we need other theatrical elements also, okay? As I said that, it is not a matter of suppressing speech in theater, but of changing its role and especially of reducing its position, of considering it as something else than a means of constructing human characters to their external ends. Since the theater is concerned with the way feelings and passions conflict with one another and man with man in life. So here actually, Antonin Artaud's intention is to create a new theatrical language which would allow the director to work as a creator instead of a translator of the author. So here just Artaud wants to distance theater from the printed words only to rely on other things that a theater needs apart from just the words. So in the essay Oriental Occidental Theater, Artaud also remarked that he didn't see art and life as separate, because for him, theater is the place where life finds its manifestation. As I said that, the domain of theater is not psychological, but plastic and physical. It is not a question of whether this physical language of theater is capable of achieving some of the psychological resolution as the language of words, whether it is able to express feelings and passions as well as words, but whether there are not attitudes in the realm of thought and intelligence that words are incapable of grasping, and that gestures and everything partaking of a spatial language attain with more precision than they. So it basically means that words cannot do all the possible things that a theater needs. So apart from words, we also need the other things that are suitable to acting, that are suitable in a theater. Because the domain of theater is not psychological, but physical. So that's why Artaud do not see theater as a mere platform for presenting social conflicts, but he sees it as a tool to express objectively certain secret truth into light. And according to Artaud, an image, an allegory or a figure have more significance in theater rather than the speech. And in this connection, in this respect, he says that this is why true beauty never strikes us directly. The setting sun is beautiful because of all it makes us lose. Artaud also remarked that the Oriental theater of metaphysical tendency contrasted to the Occidental theater of psychological tendency. So it means that the Oriental theater means the theater with metaphysical tendency, and Occidental theater means the theater of psychological tendency. Okay. So friends, thus in this way, Artaud made a revolutionary theory regarding theater and the language of theater, which opens a new window in theoretical presentation for no doubt. So friends, this is the full note on Artaud's views on Oriental Occidental theater. Hope this video will help you for sure. And if it is, then please give it a like, share this video and subscribe to my channel. So bye for now. See you in the next session very soon.